Hi guys, now as a part of our Indian national movement, we are going to discuss about the Swadeshi movement now. Swadeshi movement was the first ever non-violent movement organized against the British rulers in India. See, as we discussed earlier, we have a violent and non-violent methods, but this is a purely non-violent method by encouraging our own goods. Swadeshi means domestic goods and discouraging the foreign goods. It was held between 1905 to 1908 as a protest against Lord Curzon's decision to partition the Bengal state into two provinces as East Bengal and West Bengal. This movement is known as Swadeshi movement due to the call given by leaders urging people to boycott foreign goods and use only domestically produced goods. Our leaders or the members of the Indian National Movement gave a call to the common public to actively participate in this movement by boycotting the foreign goods and use only domestically produced goods. This movement is also known as Vande Mataram movement due to the popularization of the song. As you all know, Vande Mataram is a song written by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. Okay, so that is nothing but Vande Mataram means hailing Mother India. So this song was popularized during this movement. As the main demand of the movement was cancellation of Bengal partition, it was also known as Bengal Unification Movement. See, the main demand of those people was to unify, with the Bengal was bifurcated into two parts. It is a unification movement, means to unite these broken parts or split up parts. Now everybody got united. That's why it has got the name Bengal Unification Movement as well. So leaders like Anand Mohan Bose, Lokamanya Bala Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Ajit Singh, Syed Haider Raja, Bipin Chandrapal, Chidambaram Pillai and others actively participated in the Swadeshi movement. So you know, all our leaders have actively taken part in this movement non-violently, only encouraging the domestic goods and boycotting the foreign goods. Further, see, the leaders of the extremist phase conducted the movement as a complete popular movement by taking recourse to non-cooperation and passive resistance. See, the extremist phase leaders, though actually they have adopted violent activities, especially in this, they made it a popular non-violent activity. Means popular in the sense most of the people will take part in the movement, and it's through non-cooperation and passive resistance. Non-cooperation and passive resistance means just not obliging or showing your obedience to the government rules and government methods. Suppose as I mentioned earlier as well, if there is some rule to be followed strictly by the citizens, they will refuse to follow them. If you say the time is 9 o'clock to the school, further you will say I will come at 10 o'clock or I will not come at all. In this way, at every step people resisted their methods. And the methods used in the movement includes boycott of foreign goods. See, foreign goods in the sense textiles, you know, machineries, everything, all sorts of kind of goods used to import from foreign, that is European especially. But we people never accepted them as a part of this movement. So boycott of public services and government education institutions. See, the people who are working in the government offices, they did not go to office. There was a literal pen down. Pen down in the sense, you're not going to work for the government anymore. And government educational institutions as well. As a teachers, as students, nobody participated or taken part in the activities. And organizing strikes, buns and hartals. You know, strikes, hartals, buns, to protest something, we go for that. So they organized all these strikes, buns and hartals to show our non-conformance to their rules. That is a non-cooperation, absolute non-cooperation. So picketing in front of shops selling foreign goods and public burning of foreign goods. Wherever there were textiles, foreign textiles, they used to burn foreign cloths, and picketing in front of the companies or factories which were manufacturing foreign goods. No, people used to go and stop or halt the machineries there, and holding festivals and melas for mobilizing public support, etc. In order to spread this message to everyone and create awareness, they used to go for a public gatherings, mobilizing public support at exhibitions, holding festivals and melas at different points where people used to participate. On the whole, this movement has left an indelible impression in spreading nationalist feelings among the Indians. It was able to check the dominance of colonial feelings and British superiority in institutions. Through this movement, that is the non-cooperation movement, we have expressed that you are no good for us. So this was only to check the dominance of colonial feelings and show them that you are no way superior to us in any way. This is the topic about non-cooperation. Thank you.